afternoon. Very important in the first game.
Yes, definitely. They're obviously, they're a formidable.
And we saw Ding Ning tested, notably.
The positive attitude and play your game. And you never
back.
Yeah, and that's a great map of the games. Some great table tennis.
And a different proposition.
Short pimples, long pimples, reverse rubber.
In their mind what type of return they're going to get and how the player might return. And
all in, already in the head. Obviously, it doesn't always happen. They are
throw it a little bit higher. Incredible service. Tomahawk. Every time she does.
The opponent to actually see what spin it is.
Reach the final against Japan.
One.
Forehand.
Two. Three. Five.
These two players have only played once before. That was in 2014 at the Asian Games.
More problems. Reaction time, split second.
You have to keep changing your tactics on that.
Players play the percentage shots on the first one to get themselves into the run early or force it. Sometimes make errors if you force too early.
Dingy's had that much practice against playing against that type of ball. They'll have played all sorts of things.
Of course, first up, then Li Xiaoxia, the current Olympic champion. And third on will be Chen Szu-Yu, of course.
Seven.
No place in the team. Game three. Crucial that she tries to make a dent in this first match of the semi-final. Multiple winner on the world tour. A bit of angles on the left-handed Ding Ning's forehand.
In the baseline, or she's getting the spin back.
Oh. Semi-final.
11-4.
And 11-4 sees it, so it's 11.